So this video is on a cash flow management system. As we all know, cash is king. This system was built to monitor the movement of funds in your business. But keep in mind, this system is based on tables and pivot tables. With that in mind, let's get started. Before I introduce the cash flow system itself, let us go through the entire workbook. You would notice this workbook has a lot of colored sheets, so let's start with the green color. The green color essentially indicates input. These are sheets in which all your data is entered. The first sheet is the bank balance sheet. This sheet is the only sheet which is actually different from the rest. The first thing you would need in the bank balance sheet is the bank balance as at a certain date. Once you have this, place the date on the columns A, G, and H, and use the title bank balance on column B and I. You would need to give a name for the bank account, so I named mine LKR bank account 1, and a reference. You would need to use this reference later. If you have money in the account, you would need to put in the balance as at that date. You would notice my balance is in a negative format. I've done this because red gives a sort of contrasting effect. So you would notice there is a bank balance in your account at the time. So you would also notice I have two types of accounts. I have an LKR account, which is my local currency, and a USD account, which is my foreign currency. If you go back to the cash flow sheet, I have allowed the user to place in one additional type of foreign account. So you can place the exchange rate over here. Once we got our accounts, we can head over to the overhead sheet. This sheet is where we can enter our bills and projections. As you can see, there are three date columns. The first column is the invoice date in column A. Then in column G is the date in which is essentially the date of payment. And column H is, if you are unable to pay on that date, the next available date. The status indicates if the bill is urgent or if it's currently due. So let me start by giving an example. Let's assume I have a bill which I received maybe 10-12 days ago. So let's start by adding a date. Let's say it was the 12th of June 2022. It is an overhead. And let's say I'm paying my internet bill. Let's say I would need to settle the bill on the same day. So I'm placing 12th of June, and my revised date of transaction is also the same. The moment I put the letters due, you would notice the column N turns orange, which means it has passed the due date by 10 to 30 days. Let me fill up the sheet. Notice this date has passed its due date, the revised date of transaction. The moment I refresh the sheet, the date changes to the 24th. Today is the 23rd of June. It would always show one date ahead. Let's assume I paid this bill today. So let's assume I use the LKR one account, which I got from my bank balance over here. And I paid by check, so let's give it a check number. And let's say I paid it. So there are two ways you can settle a bill. One way is to indicate pending, the other method is to type in done. So let's first type pending and refresh the sheet. You would notice it cleared from this sheet. It moved into the pending sheet, which is over here. I'll explain the pending sheet in a little while. So as of now, it's come back here. Let's go back to the overhead sheet and actually let's move forward. So, since we have an understanding on how the system exactly works. So I have put in some raw material purchases in my RM purchase sheet. You would notice I have set USD payments as well as LKR payments. After which I have some loans to pay in my loan sheet. You would notice some of them have passed their due date as well. And finally, my income sheet. So this is where all my income comes. And you would notice I have put all my amounts in negative format in order to give a contrasting effect. Similarly, if you look at the bank transfer sheet, if I'm moving funds from one account to the other, I would put in my reference in which I'm taking the money out and re-entering the money back in into my new account. So this is how bank transfers would be done. So let's come back to the pending and done sheets. These are essentially completed transactions. I use the pending sheet when I have, for instance, given out a check to a supplier, but the check has not cleared from my bank account yet. Hence, it's still pending. At the end of the month, if I check my bank statement and the check has gone through, I can go to the status column and change the status from pending to done. So let's assume that has happened for my electricity bill. I'm going to go here and change my status to done. And let's go back here and just refresh. It has now cleared from the pending sheet and moved to the completed done sheet, as you can see here. The purple sheets are the bank account sheets. If you look at LKR1, you can see the transactions which have taken place in the LKR account. So, for instance, the transfer, 50,000, and my payment of the internet bill, as you can see. Since we are using pivot tables, there is a chance where some of these status may move around up and down. Always keep the bank balance at the top and the done transactions at the top. So you will always have a running balance on the right side of your screen. If you, by any chance, if the done transactions is at the bottom here, simply move it up by dragging up right there. And these are all pivot tables. There is nothing special in this sheet, but it's for everyone to use. So finally, so I have LKR1 account, I have the LKR2 account, I have my USD account. The USD accounts shows a converted amount as well. So just so you have, if you, in case you need to convert your transactions to rupees, you would have a converted amount available for you. But this would be your dollars. So finally, you would notice there are two cash flows. I have a cash flow and cash flow 2 over here. The first cash flow sorts based on what's urgent and due. So according to this, since my pending transactions have gone as well, you would have roughly 11 million in your account. All your dollar accounts are converted and shown as rupees. The second cash flow sorts based by date. So it would look you can ignore the past transactions and you look through the future transactions. So since today is the 23rd of June, the future transactions start from the 24th of June, and all your payments start falling in, and what comes into the future is shown. There are buttons available in each of the sheets. So you have the overheads, credit, RM purchases, bank transactions, cash in hand. All these guide you to the essential sheets you require. To help you move quickly through, the cash flow button essentially refreshes. After completing every transaction, always press the cash flow button to refresh the entire pivot table. So that's about it. I want to thank you all for watching. We'll catch you in the next video. Take care.